And now our last tool under keyword research is Rank Tracker. Again, like Product Tracker and the keyword list tool, you can see that it is arranged like this with all these tabs at the top. I'm going to go back to our washable pee pads one again. And you can see that we have this one product active right now on Amazon. If I click on this product, it will take me into an analysis of how this listing is doing. So it's generating a chart of historic performance for my top 10 keywords on this particular listing. When I hover over one of them, it kind of isolates it to make it easier for me to see how it's performing. We've inverted the y-axis so that zero is at the top to make it more intuitive, because with Amazon sales rankings, the lower the number, the higher you're appearing in the search results. So like number one means you're in the first spot in the search results. If you've got a BSR, bestseller rank of something like 1,000, then you are appearing far down in the search results. So we've inverted the y-axis to make sure that this line is showing you how you're moving up and down in the search results for this keyword. Looks like when people are searching for something like potty pads, our product is actually kind of hovering down lower in the search results because that's not quite as relevant to the product we sell compared to something like reusable pee pads for dogs. So my default view is the last 60 days. You can set this to however much time you want to look at, but I love this tool because it really helps me understand whether the keywords that I have included in my listing are actually contributing to moving my product up in the search results or whether they're just doing nothing. So we've got the top 10 ones here, but I could choose any of them if I wanted to from my huge list. And then when I scroll down here, we've got a table that shows me all the keywords lists that I've associated with this listing, what the search volume was for the last 60 days. This column is my favorite because it tells me when somebody searches for the phrase reusable pee pads for dogs, my product is actually appearing in organic rank number 13 on page number one. But when somebody searches for puppy pads, pet training pads, my product is showing up in organic rank number 132 all the way down on page three of the search results. So this column is great because it tells me like which keywords have I included that are really helping me show up at the top of the search results. And are there certain keywords that I should either eliminate from my listing or maybe I need to spend some money on some advertising campaigns to kind of surface my product for those keywords. The little arrow will show me whether my product has actually moved up or down since the last time the data was refreshed. And again, we give you the suggestion for the PPC bid, as well as how easy it might be for you to have an impact on your sales rank by including this keyword in your listing. Last thing I should point out is when it says in the listing, you can see here that this green check mark, that means that this entire phrase is included in my listing as it is written. If it says partial, that just means that part of this phrase does appear. So probably the word mat appears somewhere in our list or the word dog does, but not the phrase dog mat. So that could be an indicator that I might want to actually include the specific phrase dog mat if it's performing particularly well. So Vova, how do you, because you're an experienced seller, how do you monitor the performance of your products? How often do you go in and change your keywords in your listing?
So first, I wanted to say, Edmund, that we can also track competitors here, not necessarily only our product. We can plug in a competitor.
We can plug in a competitor, Ace, and
just to see their positions. Even in the product research phase, we can see how is it changing, what's going on. We can kind of follow what others are doing. But we definitely are using this tool all the time because we want to see our keywords. And let's say we have a grill brush, and grill brush usually would rank for many different relevant search terms. So let's say grill brush Bristol free, Bristol free grill brush big, and just many, many, many of these, right? We need to gather all the relevant ones, of course, as we've done before in the keyword scout. We find all the relevant keywords, we process all the irrelevant ones, we build the listing with the title, bullet points, then we track them. Right. And we track them all the time because we have many of them, and manually we cannot really go every day on Amazon and type in grill brush Bristol free, scroll down, and that would just take ages.
See where our product appears.
And back in the day, like I would say, I mean, 2016 when I started, probably, I don't remember if there were keyword trackers. I would say probably yes, but I think those who started in the Wild West of like 2012 or something, I think people just actually tracked it manually, right? So I wouldn't say that we do it daily, that we're daily tracking the keywords. Definitely at least a few times a week we gotta see, because what happens if a keyword drops, we want to see why it dropped. And what happens maybe somebody let's say if we're running ads for that keyword, somebody outbids us and we lost our top of search, let's say, position, right? And we haven't been following like for a week or two, and suddenly we see that we're dropping because we're getting more less sales actually for that keyword. So if we were to check it beforehand, if we're checking our keywords, we would see, hey, we started dropping. Hey, what's going on? Why are we dropping on this keyword? Or maybe we're actually are doing some sort of marketing campaign for a specific keyword, and we see, is it working or not? So it's a really useful tool. And definitely any seller that's selling, in my opinion, must put all his relevant keywords that he's actually getting sales from, or if not yet getting sales, the keywords that the competition is getting sales from, so we'll know where to rank those. And then we'll just follow along and see if we're going down, up, and what's going on. And and as you mentioned, Edmund, if it's we should do that actually before we start selling. So we want to have, at least from my experience, we want to have, let's say, a keyword, if it's like grill, brush, Bristol free, we would love to have it exact in the listing itself. So partial is also good, right? So we at least have like Bristol free here and grill brush here. But if we have it as a phrase, it seems like search engines love that. And also people that search for these things, when they're reading your title, it will click in their mind. Let's say if they type grill brush Bristol free and they see in your title grill brush Bristol free, they'll be like, oh, okay, so that's what I'm looking for, right? So that helps you with CTR and with
And I love what you said about monitoring, like, oh, what changed or why did this change? I meant to point out this little view annotations bit here under the graph. If you decided to include a new keyword that you think will perform well, or you decide to increase your PPC budget for a particular keyword, you would want to make a note of that here so that then if you see a corresponding change for that, you can see, oh yeah, on October 14th, I did this and then I noticed this change afterward. Some of Jungle Scout's plans actually allow you to have multiple seats. So if you have a slightly larger team of people who are monitoring multiple products, then you can allow those people to also come in and put these notes here so that everybody, you know, is looking at the same data. So
awesome.
Yeah. So that's Rank Tracker. I think that's great, Vova, what you said, a couple times per week, because unfortunately it's not just set it and forget it. You can't just write a listing and then let it go. It's like a constant work in progress, and Rank Tracker makes it a lot easier to stay on top of its performance.